Okay.
Oh boy.
Okay. Mad Hog?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so you're not, so you get up in the morning and Mad Hog does not seem to, be around.
Manny. Mad Dog is not in this world yet. He might come.
Mortal?
You mean you're not born yet? Wow. That's really weird then, since you're here.
No, Manny is not in this particular alternative dimension in which there are fairies. Yes.
Okay, where is Manny?
So I have a question. Does the communication link is the communication link open yet?
Not yet. He hasn't set up yet, but I will say so though at some point.
Okay. I see.
I need to take off my jumper here because it's gotten hot all of a sudden for some reason.
I'm not surprised.
Well, the heating's not on, if that's what you mean, Demon Ox.
Okay, the man's going to bring up the point that Manny is not there.
Yes, Chloe notices this as well.
Don't worry, guys. Don't worry, guys, Manny's coming.
Okay.
He's coming real fast. In fact, yes. He's put on his...
gotta go fast spell.
He's gotta go fast spell in a true magic.
I call it Roadrunner.
So you know he's coming real fast at you.
I call it Roadrunner.
In fact, he's coming so fast he might not know how to actually stop. Do I have to roll for that?
Roll a dexterity check.
Oh gosh, no.
Here we go again.
Don't bash into any walls.
13.
That's not so good. Okay, make a strength check.
Good. That should actually go swimmingly. 44. Yeah.
Okay, so you managed to collide with the side of the building that you use for your meetings. and you have so much momentum that you're able to go through the entirety of the room and go through the other wall out the other side.
Yeah!
Please tell me the building did not crumble.
You're tumbling all over the place the entire time too.
Basically,
because you're trying to stop yourself.
Do I actually get in front of the party after I crashed everything? You know, like doing the Kool-Aid Man entrance.
And the room next to them was the ladies' bathroom.
Now, here's the bad part of this.
Uh-oh. Oh, no.
Nope.
You take 50 damage.
Oh, shit.
Well, I guess I'm dead. Well,
you'll be severely injured at that point.
This is like fall to the floor that way.
I guess Manny just cries for help with the last remaining strength he has. Help! Please!
Now, what did we learn?
Help! Please! Cindy! The baby! Help!
What? He's calling help from the baby?
No, he's calling
baby, help me!
You're unconscious now.
Get out, you're cold.
I'll go heal Manny.
Okay, so it takes some doing, but you're able to heal him back to consciousness.
So he actually was in front of us.
He went through the room that you guys were in and out the other side. So Solomon has to go about 13 feet out the other side to get to him.
Okay. That's funny. I'm glad that it's funny because the next part will not be as funny.
Yeah, because Chloe's all like,
I threw 34 more for my healing spell.
Yeah, I mean, there's no like time constraints here. You can heal in the full. There's nothing that's going to stop you from it.
Wait,
so you don't even need to make the rolls really.
How much charisma do you have, then, Matty?
My charisma is 21.
Oh, okay. Okay, that's good to know, because I need to know this for future reference.
I did tell you, Devar.
I've just forgot, okay? And I wanted it from the...
horse's mouth.
Okay, yeah, the horse's mouth.
Okay, yeah, so Manny is now conscious again.
Yeah, Manny just gets up frantically, starts shaking Solomon on the shoulder. Cindy and the baby, they're nowhere to be found. They're disappeared.
What?
Nobody's seen them. Chloe, thank God I found you.
When did you last see them?
Chloe, call Titania. Do something. Ask her where Cindy and the baby are.
Yeah,
yes, so good thing.
Chloe then decides to try and telecommunicate with Cindy to see if she can get a hold of her. Cindy, you getting this?
Nope.
Huh.
Okay, that means she's either unconscious
when
or
when did you last see them?
It was... When did I last see her, actually? Come to think of it.
Did you last not see her in your bed last night?
No, it was last... She didn't come... She didn't... She was out... Susan told me she was out to go shopping, and she didn't return. Fuck.
Out of character, I have a bad feeling about this.
You can say that.
I have a bad feeling about this.
You can say that in character as well, honestly. Yeah. I think everybody's a bit feeling
about because
this.
I'm going to guess what this scenario is going to be.
Yeah, I'm going to seriously tear up the entire city in order to find her. Yeah. And unless you do something to just call Manny or reassure him or anything else, because he's about to just go on a rampage about now. Mm-hmm. You know what happened now. So.
Yeah. So
my guess is that someone has kidnapped her and we have to exchange the gem to her or something.
Or we could call Titania to see what she thinks or find.
Yeah.
Given her omnipresent knowledge.
Yeah.
Let's do that.
Yeah, so Chloe at first notices Manny's unrest and goes to him and puts her hand on his shoulders and goes like, Manny, we will find her and Summer. We'll find them both. They'll be okay.
Understand, this is the one thing, this is the one job I'm supposed to do. I'm supposed to be a good husband. I'm supposed to be a good father. I cannot be anything. I am nothing without them!
Manny, we will find them. Trust us. We're here together now. So then she communes with Titania to ask her this question to see if she can get a hold of her.
Okay, you'll have to ask the question specifically. Remember, it's timed.
Yes, I know, for 1 minute.
Okay, we will start in 4 seconds. 3, 2, 1, go.
Hey, Titania. Sorry to bother you, but I need to know something. It seems Cindy and Summer has disappeared, and I wondered if you would know what has happened to them.
Sadly, I'm unable to find their location.
Thanks.
I apologize.
It's okay. You can only do so much, as can I, so thanks for at least trying.
Does this mean they're not in this dimension?
Oh, then we haven't found out this yet.
Yeah, so she doesn't know, so...
I asked that from Titania.
Chloe is the only one who can talk to her, so I'm just going to cut off the connection here because there's really nowhere else I can, you know, could go from here because she said she doesn't know and cannot sense them. Anyway, I'll see you later, Titania. So she cuts off. Okay. Yeah. So she goes like, she said she can't sense them.
Does they're in some another dimension or something?
I would hope not.
Many casts.
What is
again.
The
many
extent
casts
of...
go fast and runs towards Warren's location.
What is the extent of Titania's power?
Pretty damn good.
She's must be an only present being.
Yes, she could sense. She could talk, detect someone all the way in Australia.
And there's not the possibility that she would have lied to us to protect Cindy or something.
That's a good point, but I don't think she had any reason to lie to us.
Okay, so Wang is in his usual abode.
Yes.
Okay.
Warren! Warren, for frick's sake! Do I know how to break this time?
That's a good question. Roll a dexterity.
God damn it! Magdan, I keep
Stop running into things. I keep sabotaging
myself, but it's funny. Okay.
I get it. Many subconsciously self-destructive.
15. Yeah, pretty much.
15? Okay, roll another strength check.
Oh, God!
He has a dimension thing, so it doesn't matter what if you hit the wall.
Man has
it.
A secret death wish. It makes all sense now.
36.
Okay, well, you collide into the side of the dimensional wall here. It does not give because it is not made of an actual substance. So, you are going to take 29 damage.
Welp!
At least you're not dead this time.
Well, I am not half dead this time, so let's see. I'm 25.
Minus 4.
Minus 4, goddammit.
So you're injured.
I'm injured. Well, I go limping inside Warren's tent. Warren! My child! My wife! They're gone! They're not in this dimension anymore! I need to use the fucking portal!
Calm down, Manny. What was that?
I'm not calming down. Cindy and the baby, they've disappeared. Nobody has seen them. Not even Titania knows where they are. They are not in this world. They must be in the next dimension. Bring me to the next dimension!
Which dimension
I don't
you
know what
for?
You're talking about!
Help okay. me, please!
Okay, so Chloe, I'm going to, at this point, have Chloe have the telecommunications open since Manny left in such a hurry.
Like, what do you mean by next dimension?
Weren't you trying to open a portal to something? Maybe they brought her there. I'm running out of time. Who knows what's happening to them? I need...
Hold on a second.
Out of character.
Yes.
I'm actually having a thought right now out of character. Could she actually be isolating herself from the world using that cage spell?
She has immense magical powers, ones that you're not necessarily aware of.
No, but I mean, would Titania not be able to actually see her if she was covered with the cage spell?
You don't know. I think it's kind of too much to jump to those kinds of conclusions yet. I mean, there are magics that exist that can protect one from being detected.
Have you seen the state Manny is in? He cannot think rationally.
Okay, he is going to cast calm emotions on you.
Slats on Solomon's theory.
Okay, do I resist it?
That's up to you.
What do I roll?
You'd have to roll a wisdom check to resist it.
I wisdom check. Okay, in that case, 6! I don't!
Nope, okay, so you are now calm.
I am calm. I am burning on the inside, even though I am not showing.
So you recollect your thoughts and are able to talk more clearly now and rationally.
Okay. So I explained the situation to him, the fact that Cindy and the baby are missing, have gone missing. Nobody knows where they are. Nobody can find them. He couldn't find them anywhere. So they could not be reached telepathically via telepathic communication. So Chloe tried to contact Titania for indications, but not even Titania will be able to reach them. What is the conclusion to that?
Again, too quick to jump to conclusions that they are not on this realm, especially considering Titania is a deity, she may be able to see into other realms as well. There might be other types of magic at play.
Okay, at this point, Manny...
Mental rift magic's hard.
Okay, so since now he's calm, something clicks in Manny's mind due to previous experiences. Cage spells? Could she be trying to prevent from being found?
It's a possibility. I don't know the extent of Cindy's magic, so it's possible she might have that ability.
Manny has a bit of an idea from personal experience. So, okay. But even so, how can I find her? How can I find them if there's magic that's preventing us from detecting her?
Ooh, I actually had a thought there.
I do not honestly know.
Share the thought. We are open communication
here. Yes. Well, if you can't see her, then don't look for what you can see. Look for what you can't see.
Your face?
If she's hiding the presence, then she should also be hiding anything nearby. So if you can't see it into a certain location, it's not what's there, it's what's not there.
Okay, that's actually a fairly good idea. Can I do a sweep of the town looking for strange abnormalities such as that?
Well, most definitely. Can
we all do that?
Yes, you can all. I mean, it's up to each character.
Can we consult Titania and ask her to tell where Cindy isn't?
See, that's beyond the scope of what she can do in 1 minute.
I know. Cindy is not in Australia, she's not in New Zealand, she's not in Alaska, she's not there or there or there. Yeah, that'll take about a minute.
I was thinking of phrasing it as,
could you ask her to see where she cannot see?
Surely, I could have just had a thought myself. What if we could have the Fae Guard look around beachside? I mean, it's one of their own is missing, so
that should be.
You can get as many people involved as you want. I mean,
Manny's way ahead of you. He's rallying the people in the main plaza. these have gone missing. Please help find if you see any abnormalities, things that are missing, things that are not supposed to be like that. Contact your local Fae Guard or myself personally if you have to.
Okay, so.
Massive
essentially
search.
Have the whole populace look.
Okay.
Population.
So, while you are out, you encounter Susan, who is also looking for Chloe.
Cindy.
Fervently. Cindy, I should say, sorry. And she is like, someone dropped off this letter. I didn't get a good look at him. It was just like someone rang the doorbell and rang away from the door. I didn't get much of a look at him, but it's addressed to you, Manny. Maybe it might have some kind of clue.
Oh no. If I find a ransom message with words detached from a newspaper glued to the piece of paper, I'm going to be very disappointed.
Yeah, because you know, nowadays most people use typewriters.
Oh boy. What's this then?
Oh, Ross is going to.
Oh, I think Ross is typing.
She didn't left him, right?
Don't you love me, Cindy? Don't you love me? Oh,
I see.
We can't.
Nah, I'm not looking either because since Ross is doing a secret message, I thought it's best I don't see it.
Yes, we should hopefully get the stream now. It is down.
Okay, so I've read the contents of the letter and I believe I'll act accordingly.
I see.
I don't like the sound of this.
Accordingly means I will decide an action and I will proceed with it. In the meantime, I'd like the search to continue.
What did the letter say?
I am not telling you. Duh.
Oh, gosh. I don't like the sounds of it that he's in not fact, telling us.
Okay, here's the thing. I am not telling, as in I am not telling anyone about this letter. Not anyone is... I am not telling anyone. Am I being too subtle here?
Not basically, telling... No, but basically the Pleasant Player characters aren't aware of it.
Oh, okay, so we are not connected by our minds.
You're collected by your minds, but it's, again, not something that he'll say, oh my goodness, I found the letter, you guys! He didn't say that in-game.
He's not mentioning it.
So, okay, so... Okay.
So he didn't mention it in his mind when he received a letter.
No, he has to intentionally broadcast it. It's like, you know, you have to intentionally talk.
Right, so we're not in the know of this letter at all, and Manny's not telling us about this letter, and we, as characters, don't know about any letter.
Yeah.
I don't like this so far. We were meant to go look for gems, and now it's like, oh boy, we have a missing person on our hands.
I guess we have to split the party.
No, no, that's too dangerous at this point. I mean, good lord, remember the first battle we had, Demonox?
Yes, I remember.
We got creamed without the other two party members.
No, we won it, we just didn't win it that well.
Yeah, we were really...
A lot of typing going on.
Yeah, I think it's because, you know, whatever... It's think of it like as the...
I'm waiting for the ping.
Mischief ping. Knight. Think of it like Mischief Knight. Basically, there's secret strategies going on that we're not in the know of, but the audience is most likely is in the know of.
So, as I told you guys, that it was going to all hinge on decisions made by Manny.
Oh, no.
I did let you know ahead of time.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, I'm going to talk to me various members of the Faegar to find out what they've found so far.
They've haven't had a lot of time to scour beachside at this time, but they haven't found anything particularly unusual.
So, yeah. Okay. Manny's going to do something here. It's a secret for now.
Okay.
Okay.
What we're gonna do exactly now? If I'm gonna guess, we're all gonna be busy looking for Cindy at this point.
Yes, exactly. Yes. That's what all of your characters would be doing in game.
Yes.
So. I think really, what else could Chloe do other than look around? Like, could she discuss with people about, you know, things that we could do?
I don't know. It's very hard to make actions when you don't know what's going on.
Yes.
Right.
Especially when it hinges on one person knowing.
Exactly.
Okay, so Manny has to go see someone right now.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
So he goes to this person, and I'm going to have to do some typing here with Ross, and yes. I cannot share this information. In the meantime, you guys do what you need to do.
Yeah.
We can't seem to do anything.
I know, it's like...
Well, I guess I could go search for Cindy.
Uh-huh. Well, that's searching for her, that's a problem.
That's what we're all doing, but we're not having any luck. And...
To
think...
Hey, maybe if Cindy is hiding in one of the buildings under her seeming that we could lock her apartment and barricade it, and then she is willing to come when she's starting to starve.
No, that won't work too well. The better methodology would be to see if she's using, if force, the cage are involved, then we shouldn't be able to gain entry in at all. He wouldn't allow someone to access the building just in case they stumbled upon it.
Hmm.
Unfortunately, because there's not a lot of time has passed, we can't really say any actions have happened.
I don't like these songs.
If you have any ideas, feel free to leave them in. You know,
discuss ideas.
So yes. This gate spell hide locations.
That's the point.
Yeah, does this
well, case you might potentially know because given her extensive intelligence, she might have glanced at it in a book or something.
Should I roll for something then? Because I wasn't quite listening because I was too busy in my own thoughts trying to think of things.
Chloe, try to search for information if this gate spell, does it hide only persons or can it also hide places? If there's...
Can't hide people in general.
Let me roll an intelligence to see if I'll get this. But I don't think Ross will let me know the results of my roll.
Okay, so what was she trying to know? Exactly what...
Force cage
basically
can hide things.
Basically, researching the books, you know, can the force cage spell hide presences of a magical nature as well?
Yeah, roll your intelligence.
Okay, I've already made it. It's a 40.
Okay. So, from your understanding of the spell, it does not look like that it masks presences. However, that does not mean that it can't be used in conjunction of other spells that do.
Like stealth. What's the thing? Doesn't visibility actually hide a presence? Or they're just an optical illusion? See, it's very hard. Unfortunately, it's very hard to make decisions because we don't know what's happening.
Yeah, me neither.
I guess I'll read a book. Oh, I can use my smartphone to go on the internet.
Interwebs.
Just for listening to some music while I'm
waiting. Yeah.
But no. See, I'd run through things that I'd think, given the Mona's past history, she'd think of, and if there's no, unless there's, because she doesn't know about any note, in-game character-wise, is there any chance I'm going to bump into the nanny?
Let's see, I'm going to say a 10% chance that you just happen to bump into her.
Yeah, there's a lot of people. I'm looking around, so...
Unfortunately, no.
Don't we have the Fanny's phone number?
Well, we should do, but...
You can talk to him with the mind, you know?
Yeah, no, but I think he said the nanny.
I'm looking for the nanny.
Because if we hear about the nanny, we might learn about the note.
Yeah. But then again, Manny read the note. I don't think the nanny did.
No, but she was being able to tell him that she had seen the note.
Did Manny even told us that he saw the note?
No,
he didn't.
I just want to...
Now you're trying to use meta-knowledge at this point.
Nah, I know, but...
Yeah, I just want to call the nanny and ask, have she seen anything weird?
Okay, well, you call Manny's household and you get no answer.
Yes, we don't know she's out and about, so...
Well,
so Nanny is in... Where does Nanny live?
Nanny is currently live-in at the household, at the,
unfortunately, we don't know where she is.
Nanny Cindy household, I forget the
name.
At the Times household, there we go.
to be honest, I think the nanny would be out and about looking for Cindy herself still.
Exactly. So unless we bump into her, we'll meet her.
So there's no way to call her at all. And
no. Does nanny have a cell phone?
What, nanny?
Nanny.
The nanny. No clue. You have no idea.
I'm getting concerned now that we're using meta knowledge by accident here. So can we please?
Calm down for a few moments
and decide.
I just thought we might have bumped into her, that's all.
Yeah,
I rolled randomly, but no such
luck. I know, we didn't bump into her, so.
Yeah, so.
I dismissed that now, so.
I'm going to call some kind of number service and ask if they do know the.
You don't know the nanny is even looking, or where the nanny is, or that she's seen anything.
Do you know the nanny's full name?
No. I know the first name is Susan.
Okay, that's a really Susans. Common first name.
Yeah, did so we ask her last name?
You did not.
At any point. Do we have some kind of record of her?
We don't know to ask her anything.
Well, I'm going to break in this house and search for clues.
We're going to bust in the place.
You don't have to break into the house. It's currently open because of the situation.
We're going to bust down the door, damn it.
Well, okay, well, I'm going to manage and see in his apartment and search for clues. Do I find anything?
Okay, so you look around.
Yeah, well, that should make logical sense, actually, to search the try and see if there's anything left behind.
Do I need to roll something?
Roll a wisdom.
Oh, damn it. So, 17. So, 17 plus... It makes 25.
Okay. The household seems to be being kept fairly tidy, a lot tidier than last time that you were in there. Notice anything else unusual, however. It looks like the beds are made and, you know, that there was someone actively maintaining the house.
Like a nanny.
Hmm.
Oh. Unfortunately, that means it also destroyed any forensic evidence that probably was left behind.
Which is not good.
Well, if they don't know to do it, they'll accidentally remove stuff without knowing.
Well, I have no better things to do, so I'm just going to sit there and wait for someone to appear.
Okay. Just sit on his couch because Dark Side dares.
Yes, Dark Side dares. Dark Solomon.
Yeah. I check out if there's any beer in the fridge.
Good question. Cindy doesn't really drink, but Manny occasionally does, so we'll give it a 10% chance. Not in your favor, sir. You find milk, you find the orange juice, you find apple juice, some unhealthy sodas, no beer.
Well, I take a glass of apple juice and just drink it and wait for
it. Completely my thoughts. Hey, that was for the baby!
Damn you, Solomon!
One glass only.
I wonder if there's like a device I can make to help me search better. Oh, can I make binoculars?
Wait, does
or thermal drink, thermal vision?
Doesn't baby drink milk at this point?
Yes, I look. It's just that this is getting really bad now. So,
can I make thermal vision goggles? It's a tool.
I am. See you, Link.
Okay.
Okay. Madhog.
I need to do something really quick.
Devon is doing the thing that you asked of him, so okay. I need your action.
Right.
So you'll have to... this is specifically from Mad Hog.
Okay, so I'm going to say my action again in secret.
I'm gonna meander around with spy gear on. Cause I can make it.
Okay.
Is there a bookshelf in Manny's house?
There is.
Stop reading Manny's stuff.
You see it has an encyclopedia set on it.
Nothing else?
Nothing. Well, okay. Nothing else on the living room bookshelf. There's also some like, VHS tapes house. And whatnot, like standard, yeah, just, like, yeah, just like take common some, movies.
Yeah, I just take some random book and start to read it to pass the time.
Okay.
Oh, wait, okay. If I get an encyclopedia, it may raise my intelligence.
You're never going to beat your arranged marriage wife, Solomon. You got ping. Someone ping me.
Well, I'm going to call Demona and ask, has she found any new information?
Nothing yet so far.
Okay.
I must admit, I'm finding this new tool spell rather handy. I mean, I didn't realize we make thermal goggles, but...
Okay, cool. Well, I'm currently at Manny's house. I'm waiting if someone would actually appear, because honestly, I don't know what else I could do.
Sorry, I just had to respond to a friend who's been feeling rather ill. One of my other friends on Skype is rather ill at the moment, so...
Well, that's a shame. What the...
Yeah.
I hope they'll feel better soon.
I'm getting medical attention, it's just unfortunately they're still feeling ill.
Okay. So, this is just very nerve-wracking.
Very, I agree. Very nerve-wracking.
And it's not for the right reasons either.
It's good tension and bad tension.
I don't really agree with this kind of tension, personally.
Okay.
By the way, can you guys hear, like, musical stuff that comes through my system?
No. Why?
Sorry if I decide to listen to music or something while I'm waiting. I don't want Ross getting in trouble or something because I play something like copyrighted or something.
Yeah, you can, as long as it's not going through your actual microphone, you'll be fine.
Oh, I'm good then. It only comes with my headphone.
Yes.
Headset. Can anyone hear that?
No. I can't hear anything.
Good.
Okay.
I tried to call Chloe.
Actually over the phone lines, or?
No, yes, I only think. We all got the side connections going right now, so.
Oh, yeah, we have side connections. We don't even need a cell phone. Yeah, right.
Okay. Tapping buttons on the cell phone, going,
okay.
Only 8 minutes this way, mate.
Okay, so, guys, I'm glad to report that something is about to happen.
Yeah.
Something very important.
Yes.
Good something or a bad something?
Yeah.
That depends.
Yeah, I hope this will go well, because. Chloe's gonna tell you all something, because
okay.
We have to go
telepathic. Be sure to be completely telepathic. Nobody has to utter a word.
Okay. Yeah. So Chloe basically says telepathically to everybody else except Manny, we should go to the Wicker encampment.
We have a Wicker encampment.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, it's seen on the map. It's. Wicker encampment. Yeah, it's Gardenia Creefield, next to Walden Park.
Oh, yeah,
that's what that thing was.
Yeah, that's where the strange people are who want to research our safaris and have strange rituals. Apparently.
Oh, I just thought it was just a weirdo cult.
Yeah, I think it is. Corey says.
Oh. It would explain half the robes.
Well, yes. I'm going to fly in it there.
Yeah, actually, Chloe will then say, we should probably walk it there and stay incognito.
Okay.
Okay, given our tools can turn invisible.
Yeah.
No problem.
Yeah.
Mentally scowls at Solomon. Try to look natural.
Hey, Ross.
And I don't mean all natural.
Yes?
This might be a stupid question, but is there a way for me to make Solomon invisible as well?
You could make Solomon invisible, yes.
Oh, okay.
Oh, the illusion spell.
I ask...
Oh, yes. Solomon, so make yourself invisible with an illusion spell or something.
You cast the illusion spell to hide him.
You have invisibility specifically. You can use it on other people as well.
Oh, okay. I have to rewrite that because it says only for self. I only have for self as well.
Yeah, me too. I have a self spell. I didn't realize I could make other people invisible. God, that would have solved half our problems.
Yeah, it would have done. Anyway, so Chloe Gunn goes like, "We're going to the Wicker encampment. So, I think this is necessary." She puts it. She takes what looks like nothing from the ground. Mm. By the way, this is the true magic version of my invisibility spell.
Where have we gathered?
We have gathered nearby, but not at the location.
Yes.
So
yes. I don't have a map of it. I can't see anything.
Can you just answer? Did you is Cindy there?
Cindy, where?
Why are we called to search for this Wicca encampment?
Okay, so
So I guess if everybody got there and is perfectly hidden, I guess it's time for the scene to unfold.
Wait.
Hold on. I'm gonna quickly say this.
I ask that in character.
Yeah.
Is Cindy there?
Go ahead.
We'll find out soon enough if she is there. You know, she says in his mind, and you know, and we should all meet up somewhere, and then cast invisibility on ourselves. You know, as well as me on Solomon. By true magic version invisibility, Chloe takes.
Let's
what
meet
looks
in
like,
bottoms up.
Hold on.
She takes what looks like nothing in her hands, and. She throws what looks like an invisible cloth over Solomon, so he's covered by it, and she covers herself with it too.
So you're going all Harry Potter with this, gotcha.
Yep, I'm going my usual thing of stretching my hat out and pulling it down over myself for those poof.
Okay.
We do this in secret, so then...
Oh yeah, I don't mean seen.
Yeah, and then we just walk to the Wicker encampment, and we'll get there, hopefully, in time.
Yeah, good question, actually. Can we see each other while invisible?
No, you can't.
Can you imagine? It's like, oops, sorry. Solomon, that was me. Oh, sorry, Demona, I didn't realize that was you.
That's my tit.
Slap. Did I hit the right person?
No, that was my hand. Actually, be more like, no, that was my boob.
I still have the music going, I just got it down low so I can hear everybody clearly.
Okay, I'm hoping that we're there at the Wicker encampment. Ready?
Yeah, I'm hoping too, so we're...
Well, hold on, there's one couple stealthy. Things I have to confirm with Mad Hog.
Oh gosh.
Whatever, I'm probably best at stealth. You know, I'm so good at stealth, I could have really gotten away with stealing that bazooka from the army camp.
Could you get off that now? Wait. Says.
Did I lock Manny's apartment?
You did not.
Just get back all you want.
I hope not. Yeah, his couch would have been stolen.
Yeah, how did I get in there in the first place?
It oh, yeah, was true, unlocked.
It was unlocked. He walked in, he walked out.
Wait, okay, Manny this is a lock his house.
Okay, hold on. We're finally got something important now.
Okay, guys, I'll be there in a moment. Just hiring in a few little details. And I guess if Ross gives me the okay, this should do it. We should be ready.
Oh, okay. But yes, go ahead.
Okay, ooh. Alright, so we are at the Wick encampment, which I did not even know it was a thing, I'll be honest.
No, I actually didn't either, so.
Yeah, well, okay. To be honest, I'm surprised Ross would bring up half the stuff in from the map, to be honest, because the Wicker encampment was basically a storyline idea from Frank's side of the story that Danton put in.
Okay, so I show up in the middle of the encampment. I'm going to assume it's deserted and it's the middle of the night.
It's a late evening at this point.
There is nobody to be found. Clearly,
it's
otherwise.
What part of the encampment did you go to?
It was not given to me a very specific part of the camp. Just show up at the Wick encampment. That's okay. What the letter said.
You didn't spot me out.
Did I? I think I did, but let me just
No, you
check.
Didn't.
Let didn't. Me just double check. I might have made a error. Yes, I actually did put exactly where to go.
Really?
Yep.
Let me double check it.
So I guess you'll have the letter with you. I don't see why you wouldn't to double check this.
Yeah, I had to go all the way back. What? Report? Oh yeah, that fucking. It's a good thing I actually gave that mental message to the bar, so he would know where to go. Okay, so again, I completely forgot that. Okay, we are at the ritual altar in the Wicker encampment. That's
why do we
the place.
Let them build it again?
We kind of just let them be here. They're not hurting anybody, so.
Next
They're
time
like
they apply for planning permission, deny them. We're all in the head.
Okay,
at the moment,
okay.
So
what's
anything.
The deal? Okay, since when do we have a ritual altar for human sacrifices?
Actually, it's not ours.
It's a Wiccan altar.
It's a Wiccan altar. As I said before, this is from Frank's side of the story. This meta knowledge, we cannot use this. So this is technically is a place where humans are obsessed with the fairies and they want to research them. And
on here. Okay. Good to know.
This might not be a thing because Ross does not know this. So do not take this. This is
questionable canonicity, but this place does exist.
Considering what kind of weapon I've been given, I doubt a regular human will be able to get it so easily.
Okay, so you arrive at the altar.
Yes, I have the I have the dead body of Sanchez on my shoulder.
Okay.
He's bleeding profusely, and I have the stab weapon on my other hand, which is also covered in the blood substance, because obviously it was used for stabbing.
Yes, of course.
Of course. So whatever. I'm here. I did the deed. Show up. Give me back my wife and child.
Okay. And a creature appears before you.
Good.
Where are we during this?
Let me actually put this in the chat so you all can see it.
Yeah, watching.
Do we see this?
Oh, you guys do, definitely.
Because we're invisible and hopefully we just followed Manny wherever he's going. What the?
Why is there a Lilith here?
Oh my lord. Oh gosh, I can't look.
Really? Are you freaking kidding me, Ross? Are you a succubus? Really?
Yes, really.
And it turns out Cindy's the succubus.
Well, this is happening.
Okay. So, she says, it looks like you have accomplished your goal. I must say, I'm actually a little surprised that you went ahead with it, but I guess the strength of your love is even greater than I gave you credit for. Before I give you your next task, however, there's one thing I must do. You see her wave her hands around, and, let's see, I guess I will roll for this. Yeah, that's really good. Okay, so all magic in the area is dispelled.
What? Oh, really?
So all magic the fake knife is dismissed. The invisibility is dismissed.
Oh no! Well, even true magic version of invisibility.
Even true magic version.
Oh, come on!
She cast some
So, Ross, when all magic is dispelled, does that count for physical objects, too?
Yes, your knife is dismissed, as I said.
No, I mean, another one.
I'm not following what I am. You have to tell me in the chats, but so yeah, okay. I don't get it incorrectly.
Okay, I'm going to go up there. Sorry, guys.
Oh, gosh.
Where were we exactly? Were we hiding in some bush or something?
I would have thought we would have been hiding in a bush.
She says, well, I did tell you specifically not to tell anyone, and suddenly there are all these other people.
Oh no, I thought we were hiding while invisible.
Well, actually, to be honest, well, I did not actually tell anyone. It just so happens that everybody thought about this at the same time.
Yes, I'm certain that's exactly what happened.
Either way, this guy is dead. He just froze the body in the general direction, lightly in the general direction of the succubus. You can check it out yourself.
She just simply says, oh, that's not necessary. In fact, you didn't even have to go all of with all that fake blood.
Well,
oh gosh.
Well, shit.
She saw right through us.
You see, probably. That knife stabs at the soul of the victim.
Yeah. That would have been... I have never said that the blood was his.
Well, obviously this wouldn't be his if you stabbed him with the knife.
What makes you think killing this guy was easy? What part of it makes it seem easy? This is clearly my wound.
Simple, because he trusted you.
Are you kidding me? Have you ever seen how people treat me? Nobody trusts me. Do you know what kind of reputation I am? I am treated as a joke. I am a constant danger to everybody. Nobody trusts me. And I'm using what actually happened during this campaign as evidence to that. I'm trying to convince her that I did kill the guy, I put up a fight, and I had nothing to do with any of this. I have to roll for deception, don't I?
Go ahead, make an attempt.
never mind, I'll let Manny go ahead because I was going to lend credence to that by having Chloe says something along the lines of...
I have a good news for me.
Yes?
Oh, no.
Okay, I rolled a natural 20 plus 12. Okay. So
that's really
32.
Good. Seems like...
That's pretty good.
Seems like, I believe you in that regard, but they consider you... benign, if I may be so bold. And before our conversation continues, she just turns to the rest of you. I implore you all to leave right now.
Guys, leave. I did not ask for your help.
You were acting really weird, Manny, all day, so we had to do this to see what you were up to.
Hey! You calling me weird? Fuck you, bitch! You were never my queen in the first place! I am telepathically winking at her.
Yes.
Go along. Wink emoji.
let's go with this. I do... This is my family in danger. You two never cared for anything I do or say. I'm always being the joke of the group. You have never taken me seriously. Damona, you've always treated me like some sort of fucking idiot. And I always, here I am, always there, taking it like an idiot, not doing anything because, oh, it's important to be united, right, Queenie? It's important that we're a party because we had to stay together. Really? We had to freaking, why? Because some guy who escaped from hell told us that we had to fight the demons. I say fuck to that. The only thing that matters to me is my goddamn family, and I killed this man to prove it. So you can
did.
All go fuck yourself.
In fact, you killed him a lot deader than you believe you did.
Elaborate.
Did you not notice? Have you actually checked his pulse?
Oh, no.
Well, guess I had to go there and check his pulse.
No pulse.
What?
Okay, I'm going to try and retrieve the knife, the demon knife, without her noticing, if possible.
The real one?
The real one, yes, that's on him.
Okay, make a dexterity check.
Fuck. Fuck indeed.
Yeah, that was the sort of move that the moon would be able to pull off.
I know, but it's 19.
Nope. She has very keen eyes. We lost someone.
Huh? Who's missing? Oh, Matty's gone. Oh, Matty's back.
Matty's yeah, back. Something okay. weird happened.
Okay.
Hey, you returned.
Anyway, so... So she sees you reaching for the knife. It was like... So it's like... What are you doing?
I just remembered I left the knife on him. So I'm retrieving it.
Okay. And what do you intend to do with that knife? Surely you would not be so brazen as to try to inflict harm upon me. After all, I'm the only one that can return your wife and child to you. If I would to, I don't know, succumb to mortal injury, and believe me, I'm not much of a fighter, then, well, I'm afraid there's no force in this universe that's going to reunite you with your wife and child.
Nice.
I'm sorry, but who are you?
Why are you still here?
Yeah, I thought we were going to leave. Then again,
we leave?
Yeah,
okay. I don't think Matty was in there.
Look, I'm going to keep the mental link open, but you guys have to physically leave.
Yes.
Now.
Yeah, okay. Chloe goes like, we need to think of something.
Look, lady.
As they leave.
Look, lady. I know I'm considered a brazen individual. I know. I have a bad reputation, but I am not as so stupid as to endanger the life of my loved ones. Now, what I was going to do was retrieve this knife and keep it for maybe you future peruse, if you don't mind. You know, maybe if I need to stab someone else to death.
No, that's not necessary. In fact, you can dispose of the knife if you wish.
I think I'll keep it, if you don't mind. I just put it in my pocket. There it is. It's there now. So... Where's my family?
I never said this was all. I said further instructions.
Of course. Of course there's more, so... What? Mm-hmm. Okay, let's hear it. What do you need me to do?
Well, first of all, I would appreciate it if you had no magic or effects going right now. Before I tell you what next I wish.
I have nothing going on
right
now. I
can read magical auras. I can see that there is magic still. upon you.
What are you talking about?
You are not a really good liar. If you will not terminate a thing, I will do it for you.
Ah, is she talking about this fairy?
No, I seriously have no idea what you're talking about. No, I'm seriously lost here.
She snaps her fingers, gestures again, and the telepathic link with the rest of the group is cut.
Oh, hey. That!
She could sense that.
It's a magical effect.
Well, good news, everybody. Well, bad news, everybody. I cannot listen to your thoughts anymore. So, but the good news is that it's still open between you guys. So,
yeah, some money.
Plan something, please. I had a really cool plan, not knowing what an actual demon knife does. But that did not work. So.
Guys, what do you think? Should we do something?
We should do something. Should we do something?
It would be better handy to know.
So,
unfortunately, she's holding his family as hostage in some dimension, and she's got to have held him in the dimension.
You just see her gesture again. And you need to make a wisdom save, Manny.
Oh, God. 16.
That is not good enough, I'm afraid.
Of course. Nope. Of course it isn't.
I thought it had
you are now
resistance.
Charmed.
I thought you had a natural resistance to mental spells.
Okay. Manny looks at there and goes, whoa.
She attempts to charm you because you have greater resistance than normal, so you maintain at least your consciousness.
Okay,
you still can't necessarily oppose what she says, but you're at least able to think properly throughout.
Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to use this condition to my advantage to basically lull her into a false sense of security. I'm going to say, whoa, you know? Now that I have a chance to look at you, you are dreadfully, gorgeously naked. You need some cover. What does Manny do? Manny casts.
Susan is succubus.
Before she can give me any command, I'm going to, if possible, cast the God I Go Fast to just run towards her and hug her. Just agar. Like that.
You have to actually, cast the spell versus her say anything. It's gonna be impossible.
Okay. Yeah. I'm just going to run real fast towards her and agar real quickly. I'm going to assume the distance between us is not too much. Hopefully I can take her by surprise. She would not expect such bold action from somebody as charming. I'm going to assume she's used to have complete control over somebody at all times.
Well, not with the charm spell. It does affect people differently. But anyway, so you glomp her, essentially.
And I try
and
to kiss her.
Like,
mwah, mon ami, mwah, mwah, mwah. We shall play beautiful music together.
See, it's like, well, I'm glad you're being so forward. This is what I had in mind anyway. And she just snaps her fingers and both of you vanish.
So this is what you have planned, Ross. This is how you get rid of Manny.
No, basically you are teleported to an undisclosed location somewhere.